Like many of you, Final Fantasy is a series that I grew up with. I remember falling in love with the heroes, the stories, the worlds. Everything about them was just amazing. At the time, there were very few other games creating that same experience. Throughout the years, more and more games have started to give me that same feeling. You know, we still have Final Fantasy, but we also have games like Mass Effect and The Witcher 3. When you first load up Final Fantasy XV, the developers give a special message. It's a Final Fantasy made for fans and newcomers alike. Honestly, that's a lofty goal, and in some ways the game really does get there, but not everything is wonderful in this particular fantasy. I'm Kevin with the True Gaming Network, and this is my review of Final Fantasy XV. The game begins with Noctis and his friends pushing a car across a desert as Florence and the Machine plays the old classic Stand By Me in the background. Honestly, this sets the tone perfectly. This game is about Noctis and his friends and the adventure that they share, and right from the very beginning, they're bickering at each other, they're frustrated, their car is broken down. It's honestly just like you'd imagine it would actually be. These characters are people you can really understand. As the game progresses, you'll find yourself getting to know them as you travel around the world. Don't get me wrong, it's not perfect. I mean, you literally need to watch an hour-long prequel anime to really learn about why each of the guys is there, because the game never tells you why these guys trust Noctis, why they're friends. And that should never be a requirement. But if you push through, you find a lot to love in each of the game's heroes, and that's a really great thing about this game. But this isn't a game just about the guys and their road trip. It's got an epic story, and it's really kind of okay, even though it misses a few beats. Luckily, there's no anime that you have to watch to go with it, but there's feature-length film. That's right. To get the whole story of Final Fantasy XV, you need to watch a movie and an anime series to learn about the characters. That's a tall ask for any game, and here it really does make the story better, but I'm not sure it's worth it. The story moves painstakingly slowly, taking a full 9 chapters for anything to really happen at all. And then it's over just a few hours later when you can finish the game. It's definitely okay, but it's not something that I'm going to remember years to come. Unlike most other Final Fantasies and really any JRPG in general, this game has full action combat. That means there's no waiting around, there's no thinking about your attacks. Everything happens in real time. Now there is a wait mode, but it's not on by default. That said, it is pretty much mandatory because it's the only way to scan an enemy, so if you want to see their health and find out what it's weak to, you have to play with wait mode on. On top of that, there are actually abilities and power-ups that increase their damage when they're used in wait mode, so you would be really foolish not to have it on. I don't know why it's off by default, it just seems kind of like bad design. Wait mode is alright, but really, I wish it wasn't there at all. Combat itself is far too easy. All I ever felt like I was doing was holding down the B button to automatically attack. Exciting, I know. You just hold down B, and all the combos just spring out from you. It's not really all that fun. And yeah, you can press X to dodge also, and you'll do it occasionally, but the enemies aren't really well designed to take into account that you're going to dodge them. You never know when an enemy is going to attack, they just do. None of the attacks are choreographed at all. So you just run in and hold B until you kind of feel like it's been too long, and then you hold X. And sometimes you dodge, or sometimes you get hit. Honestly, it's not all that great, except for one thing, teleporting. Teleporting is extremely fun. Seriously, it's an absolute blast. When you get a fight set up perfectly so that you're bouncing in and out, from point to point, killing everything, it just feels really good. It's very fun, and in 40 hours of playtime, the best thing is I literally never teleported somewhere I didn't want to. The game is designed really well to make sure that you are always doing what you want to do when you want to do it, which means you can pull off great tricks with the teleports, and you know that kind of consistency just doesn't happen in almost any action game. It's great, and I definitely love it. Final Fantasy XV is about Noctis and his friends and the journey they go on. I already said that. And that journey really is more than just the main storyline. The world is full of things to do. There's a bunch of mini-games, which honestly aren't really very good. You know, you do things like fishing or this weird pinball hybrid game, which seems to never end. It's really not all that much fun, but it's not bad either, and they're an okay change of pace. The bread and butter of this game are the hunts and the side quests. Hunts are basically missions where you're sent out in the world to kill a rare beast. You set things up, maybe camp out for the night, you know, eat some food to get a buff, and then you kill your target. It's simple, but challenging enough to be interesting for like an hour, which is all you really need to do it for, so it's alright. The side quests are similar, and they would be good if you were playing an early 2000s MMO. What does that mean? Well, it means there's no context to the missions. You're literally just sent out to kill some enemies, or find a collectible on the ground, or maybe you find five collectibles in a circle on your minimap. That's all. Frankly, the side quests are the worst part of the game. Last year, The Witcher 3 made waves by putting immense care into each and every single side quest. They all had their own story, and it was really fantastic. Final Fantasy XV is a complete regression. Not a single side quest seems to have a story. One of the recurring NPCs even has literally the exact same lines when you meet him multiple different times, sending you on the exact same quest just to a different area. It's really disappointing because the world itself is really cool and ripe for exploration. One thing the game does do well though are dungeons. First, you can't save in them, which gives them a little edge that not all games have. You do have to actually pay attention during them. Beyond that, they're all unique and interesting. It feels a little bit like playing Tomb Raider, but with swords and you're killing monsters. I would have liked to have some platforming challenges in there and even puzzles, though I will say that one of the in-game dungeons, which is totally optional, does have some very difficult platforming. But, you know, most of the time you're just running through killing enemies to get to the end. They're good, but some puzzles and platforming would have made them memorable and fantastic. What's there though is still pretty good. It feels great to get to the end and kill a boss and sometimes even get a new weapon. It's just fun. Achievement and trophy wise, it's all pretty easy. Final Fantasy XV isn't gonna take, you know, more than 50 hours. It's a lot, but when Final Fantasy XIII took over 100, this is a lot more tame. You know, completing the story can take easily less than 30 hours, and then you're just basically clearing up everything else. It's really not bad. The final challenge involves killing the Adamantoids, which can take anywhere from 20 minutes to 3 hours depending on your level, which is honestly kind of cool. Overall, it's definitely a solid list worth experiencing. Final Fantasy XV is a game that could have been a lot better than it is. For every good character, there's a character wasted in an off-screen death. As great as teleporting in combat is, dealing damage is just holding down a button. Dungeons are great, but side quests are just incredibly dull. I'd give this game a 3.5 stars, but I'll admit I almost gave it 4. There's something very special here despite all of my complaints. I enjoyed every second I spent on it, and I can't say that for every game, that's for sure. This is a game where if you want to find something to love, you're gonna find something to love, and sometimes that's enough. So, if you like this video, please like and subscribe, and feel free to comment and let us know what you think. I'd love to hear it. I'm Kevin with the TrueGaming Network, and this has been my review for Final Fantasy XV. Yeah, I'll think about it.